Okay, this is Alexandria at the present state. And we have added another dimension. So we've got a multi-layered piece. It's really a rather complex piece. Yet there are broad breathing spaces so that the person viewing it isn't completely overwhelmed, and they do have chances to catch their breath in between. So let's review for just a moment. In the last video, I talked about the golden mean and that spiral, that C-shaped spiral, like a seashell. And then I snap you back into here. We come around, and as you remember, we're going to put some not so brightly colored flowers in the foreground to break up this shape up in here. So we've sort of infiltrated this heavy block of a sharp edge, which was inappropriate, and we soften it up by putting this beautiful miasma, not miasma, but arrangement of flowers. So we've got this lovely vignette going on here. Look at that. Look at that shape. Oh my goodness. So yes, I'm really liking it at this point. I feel like it's got a lot of elements that I've always strived. I've been working towards this and working towards this, putting all different styles of art into one piece. That's my big thing, is I said one day when I get my own wall, which I've actually had several since then, but one day when Gretchen Schmid gets her own wall, she's going to make artwork that includes not only realism and impressionism, but abstract too. Those are like the three biggies, you know. You got super high realism, and then everything in between unto impressionism, and then from impressionism, if impressionism just keeps petering out and loses its form, it becomes abstract. But to tell a piece solely in the abstract form is to me unfathomable. It'd be like, it's incredibly boring. So it's a lot like the meeting of the two minds, of the logical and the more ethereal, the more creative, mysterious, if you will, aspects coming together to create a piece. And that's what I like to do. So here's my abstract stuff going on back in here. This essentially, like, you're like, what are those shapes, Gretch? Like, what is that? These are things, I kid you not, I can prove it. I probably have scraps of paper somewhere in a file somewhere. But those are reminiscent of the doodles that I used to do on the side of my paper during accounting class. And needless to say, I didn't do so good in that class. But it helped pass the time, and I'm using it today. All this stuff, I had to do this on the sides, all over my paper. Drove my teachers crazy. But, okay, so that is where I'm at right now. The only thing I'm going to do is I'm going to have to go and check it out, Jeremy's Cool Tones, because we all know Jeremy's really good with cool flesh tones. Not cool as in like groovy, but cool as in temperature wise. So, and I'd like to insert some of those temperatures in here. I've got these little bits of blues, which is blue skin. Mm-hmm. When you have cool light, the skin can be blue. And the other side, the opposing side, is of course warm, right? Because of the laws of the temperature. So anyway, so I've got these little cool tones, but I want to put a little bit more, but it's like, oh gosh, it's like, oh, I don't know, Brillo cream, you know, like if you use too much of it, you're just gonna muck it all up. So, you know, I wanna do it very carefully and get the right color tones in here and pick up some of these colors back in here that way. Oh, just like I did in here. I might be able to just be able to copy some of these colors on my own here, but I always love looking at Jeremy's work to get deep insights. So anyway, so I'm going to harmonize this by putting a little more of these blue tones. And I'm going to sneak them in. There's a blatant one that everybody has, and it's green. And I saw it in a painting. I jumped up on the couch when I was 5, and I saw it in the portrait of my mother. And everybody has these. It's these two little green or blue things in here. I guess they're veins. Most people have them anyway. So I don't have it there, so I've got to put it in there in order for it to be absolutely perfect in the way that I see perfection, in the way that I want it to be. So that's all I have for you today, and I hope that your projects are going well, and I hope that you will share your creations with the world as well. So happy painting!